Let's discuss the variety of competencies that you may come across when completing a competency-based qualification. There are quite a few, and the terminology might be confusing, but it is fairly straightforward. So generally speaking, the competencies can be broken down in different ways. So one of the ways they can be broken down is by splitting them into performance points or performance competencies and knowledge and understanding competencies. This is common particularly with Scottish apprenticeships and with vocational qualifications like NVQ, so some of the older style qualifications. And essentially, a performance competency is the same as a skill. So essentially, you're looking to demonstrate that you can perform that skill in the workplace. Whereas with the knowledge and understanding, you're looking to demonstrate that you understand that knowledge, and particularly that you understand it within the context of your workplace. Another way that these competencies can be split up is into knowledge, skills, and behaviours. This is quite common when it comes to apprenticeships, particularly in England. And so with this, knowledge again stands for knowledge and understanding. This is asking you to demonstrate that you know these concepts, and particularly that you know them in the context of your workplace. Skills is performance points. So this is being able to demonstrate that you can perform that skill in the workplace. It's not just that you know about it, but you can actually demonstrate, you can actually perform that skill in the workplace. And behaviours is about the way in which you perform the skill and you apply the knowledge in the workplace. So it's about the way in which you perform these skills and demonstrate this knowledge in the workplace. Another way it can be split up is assessment criteria. This is common in some types of vocational qualifications, and essentially assessment criteria enables you to take it any which way that you like. So it's not splitting up into knowledge, skills, behaviours, it's not splitting up into knowledge and performance points, it's just saying this is the competency. Generally speaking, you can tell depending on the wording of that competency as to whether it's more performance or knowledge. So for example, if it starts off with apply, then it's probably a skill. If it starts off with understand, it's probably a knowledge point, but it allows you to be more flexible with the way in which you demonstrate that competency. So those are the different ways you can split it up, and as you can see, there is some overlap. So I'll use the terminology knowledge, skill, and behaviour from now on because it simplifies things. So how would you demonstrate a skill? Well, you demonstrate a skill using assessment methods such as an observation where someone observes you perform that task. Witness testimony, where you get some testimony from an experienced colleague or mentor where they have stated that they have observed you perform that task. Or you could write up a statement where you say step by step exactly how you performed that task in the workplace. You could also use product evidence. Product evidence is a screenshot, an image, or an actual physical thing that you've built depending on the qualification you're undertaking. It says, okay, you must have been able to perform that skill because there it is, you've done it, okay? So if it's about editing videos, if you've edited a video, well, that video file, that is product evidence because you've built it. So there's different ways that you would demonstrate, you can assess the competencies around skills. Knowledge is a little bit different. So with knowledge, you're just looking to say, well, I understand this concept. But saying that you understand this concept is not quite enough. You've got to be able to demonstrate that you understand that knowledge, so you understand that concept in the context of your workplace. So it's not overly theoretical, and that's one part of it. You want to know the theory of it, but you also need to demonstrate how you'd apply that knowledge in the workplace, and that's the difference, and that's what makes vocational or competency-based qualifications different from just your regular knowledge-based qualifications. So with knowledge and understanding, the assessment should be carried out during the performance to ensure integration of theory and practice. So best practice when it comes to demonstrating a knowledge competency is to do it in the context of you performing a task. This way it demonstrates that knowledge in the context of performance. So for example, if your task is again editing videos and the concept is about copyright law, then if you're producing some evidence, whether it's written or otherwise, on editing a video, if you explain as part of that assessment that you understand copyright law and you actually follow along with the copyright regulations, then that would demonstrate that knowledge competency in the context of your performance. Okay. There might be gaps, there might be some knowledge competencies that you can't demonstrate in this way, and that's fine. The way you can demonstrate that is by answering a question on it. So that's quite typical. So you can just do a write-up and answer the knowledge competency as a question. To avoid repetition, knowledge points that haven't been done can therefore be covered in that way. Learners should be able to apply knowledge understanding within the context of their workplace. This is really important. So use workplace examples for all knowledge competencies. Don't just rely on the theory. Include work-based examples of how you've applied that knowledge and that theory in your workplace. You also want to explain how you would use that knowledge in your role. So if you've not done it, not actually applied this yet, at least explain it in the context of your role. It's not best practice to simply complete workbooks, set lists, or simulation scenarios for your knowledge-based evidence. Ideally, you're answering it in the context of your work. If it's not possible, it's not possible, and there is a way around it, just to answer some questions or do a workbook, but ideally, it's stronger evidence if you can demonstrate that knowledge in the context of your performance. The way in which you would evidence behaviours, typically you would use the same assessment methods that you'd use for skills competencies. Witness testimony in particular is excellent for demonstrating behaviours because you're getting that evidence from another person's point of view, which is really strong. But all the assessment methods that you'd use for skills can also be applied here. So this should clear up some questions that you might have when you look at unit guides or apprenticeship standards, and you come across these terminology in terms of knowledge, skills, behaviours, or performance criteria, whatever it might be. You now understand what these terms are referring to.